It's gone.
Oh!
I've been working on it for 30 years. I finally succeeded, and now it's gone.
Oh.
What are we going to do now at the International Clean Air Conference? Everybody's waiting to see it. What can I do? I'm so old now. Who is going to help me find the alpha ozone for me?
I will. I'll get it back for you.
But Catherine, it might be dangerous.
Oh, don't worry. There's two of us. Sherlock, you'll help me, won't you?
Thank you, Catherine. Oh, take these. I'm sure you will need them.
Thank you, Doctor. And don't worry, we'll find the alpha ozone for you. Now then, Sherlock, where do we start? Oh, let's see my father. He'll know what to do.
Knew about your invention?
Well, of course, Mr. Nelson did. He's an undersecretary at the Department of Environment. He's been financing the project.
And those three other men who came to the lab with Mr. Nelson, they all knew about it too.
Yes, I've got their photographs here.
What are these blue, red and white parts?
I don't really know.
Doctor, can you tell me more about these four people?
Well, as I said, Mr. Nelson is at the Department of Environment. He's retiring at the end of the year. He's been most supportive throughout the project. And this man is Mr. Blazer. He's a property developer. He's currently very involved in the development of an indoor leisure complex. The alpha ozone is to improve the air quality. And this is Mr. Flash. He's a newspaper photographer. He wanted to get a scoop on the alpha ozone story, but of course, I wasn't interested. And Mr. Pound, he's a stock market analyst, specialising in new scientific developments. People call him Antenna. He's got this huge information network stretching right across the country. He's a strange chap. He always carries two umbrellas. I hear they're all very close, all very good friends.
I see.
Right then, Sherlock. Let's get going.
Catherine, if you get any leads with Sherlock, you've got to let me know.
Yes, Dad. We'll keep in touch.
Why don't you look for a man with two umbrellas?
Look what we've got.
Isn't this Nelson's flagship HMS Victory?
Do you think there's some sort of meaning to it? Hello, Dad.
Hello.
We found this map.
Well done, Catherine. We're beginning to get somewhere now. You really do take after me. It's a lion. I've seen this somewhere before. Don't jump to conclusions. You should go and see the casinos first. Interesting. Mr. Blazer's ledger complex uses an angel in its logo.
a map.
I hear that Mr. Blazer likes gambling. Gambling casinos. Some hotels in London have got casinos. Diving equipment? What's it for? You diving for treasure? Or a monster like Nessie? Just a minute, I remember. Mr. Nelson, he does scuba diving, doesn't he?
Sherlock! We've done it at last!
So you chased that suspicious Rolls-Royce?
Yes, you should have seen Sherlock driving. He was great, really terrific. We also found some great leads. There was a set of golf clubs in the Rolls-Royce, and also some gambling chips.
I see. Fine. What am I supposed to look at through these?
For detective work, you need a magnifying glass, don't you?
Braemar Castle? What have you got this for?
I don't know, but it's beautiful. I'd like to go there.
Lovely air up here. Mr. Blazer's leisure complex is all indoors, so he's gonna need a really big gal for ozone.
Are you sure there was a UFO? You'd better go back and check.
Lovely air up here. Mr. Blazer's leisure complex is all indoors, so he's going to need a really big alpha ozone.
Can be used for travelling through time and space. Perhaps we should try using it again.
Well, if you can travel through space and time, you don't need a car.
From these pictures, the whole puzzle becomes clear. It's obviously Mr. Nelson.
Why did he do it?
Well, when he retires at the end of the year, he'd been hoping to start his own company, specialising in environmental matters. Yeah? And the Alpha Ozone would have meant instant success for him.
I see. I thought Mr. Blazer was the most suspicious. How about him?
He's a very successful businessman. He's got no need to steal from anyone. Whatever he wants, he can buy himself.
How about Antenna?
Antenna? He's just a snoop. He thought Nelson was suspicious and followed him. Any information he found, he sold to Mr. Flash. That's why they kept bumping into each other. And Mr. Flash, he was only after a big story for his magazine.
Oh, I see. Well, I'm glad we caught him. If only we could discover where the Alpha Ozone was.
Well, you two, thank you very much for all your help.
Sherlock, you're a really marvellous detective. Thank you.
Hello? Chief Constable Holmes? Yes? I see. Has he? Fine. Thank you very much. Mr. Nelson is at Loch Ness, and he's disappeared.
Maybe he's looking for the Alpha Ozone. But if it's in Loch Ness, he'll never get it back. That lake's far too deep.
Such a wonderful invention. How sad.
At least Nessie will be getting some clean, fresh air.
Oh, Doctor. Incidentally, has anybody seen the warp belt? I can't seem to find it.
I bet you didn't neutralise it properly. I expect it's spinning off somewhere into the future.
Catherine, I had a call from the National Institute of Rescue. They want some help with a very confidential investigation. Now I wonder who could help them.
I will. And you too, Sherlock.
Sherlock, you've spent too much money. I'm going to take something out of your wages. I thought you could do it, Sherlock, but now time's run out.
Dad, can you give us some help?
Try the mall, or perhaps the map. And also those three colours, blue, red and white.
What do you think we should do next?
I think the man with the two umbrellas is probably the key.
Dad, we couldn't find anything.
Nothing. What about the man with two umbrellas? Did you find him?